Thanks so much for that wonderful introduction. I'm elated to be here to deliver this very distinguished lecture. And I'm glad to be in the state of Kansas, the place where John Brown started. So I know I'm among good friends. I also like to thank the, particularly the faculty and the students of the African and African American Studies program for hosting me, from fetching me all the way from the airport in Missouri. Has sparked a renewed concern about racial profiling, as well as the events in Ferguson, and the need for criminal justice reform. Nearly a week after the verdict, the president used the bully pulpit to speak freely about the problems of racial profiling of black men and propose some modest reforms to address racial bias in the criminal justice system. Obama sent Attorney General Eric Holder, who I'm quite disappointed about, resigning today, to Ferguson, Missouri, to signal his concerns about the shooting of yet another unarmed black man by police or vigilantes. Sending Holder to Ferguson was an unprecedented move. In no time in recent history has the U.S. Attorney General got so directly involved in a local murder case. Indeed, the Justice Department is doing its own parallel investigation of the murder of Michael Brown. The president did the right thing. And the president who in the first term was viewed by supporters as the president who happens to be black, which I don't hear much of that phrase these days, and could therefore only support universal policies, now seems to be promoting modest, targeted policies such as his My Brother's Keepers initiative. And even before Ferguson, the Attorney General called for the discretion in the mandatory sentencing of low-level and nonviolent crimes that sends thousands of black and brown men and women to prison each year.